We like simple displays. It's really soothing to the eye. And how you can accomplish that is repetition. And what you'll notice in this display here is, you know, green bottle gourds, other different types of green gourds, gray gourds, white gourds. But the color ties in because they're repeated throughout the whole display. On top of it, right behind me, you can see the old white screen door. Yeah, you might find this in your own junk pile behind one of your old sheds. If not, you can go to a thrift shop or an antique shop. If you look at the rocking chair right here, it's green, so it matches the gourds. And if you look at it real closely, you'll notice part of it's broken. So you can find that virtually anywhere. And then in addition to that, you might have an old stool, a birdhouse, an old bench. You know, anything like that you can use in these displays and just fill it in with a few ornamental grasses. And as we walk over here to another corner display, you know, just an old bed frame used in this display. And, you know, instead of hanging ornaments, what we're doing right here is hanging gourds. And these are gourds and things you can grow in your own garden. Just about everything that you're going to see in these displays here, we've grown in our own garden. You know, a gourd might take an area of 10 by 15 feet. You know, a pumpkin might take a 20 by 20 area, but you can take some parts of your garden you don't use or abandoned parts around your home and plant your gourds and pumpkins like we've done here. And you notice here that all the gourds are uniform and all of a similar size and color. So it sort of ties in this whole display together, which is really soothing and calming on your eyes. The main theme or thought through this display is brown. And if you look, it ties in the whole display together as one. The brown fork, you know, the little old brown plow, and behind me a brown wheel. And not only that, I got, you know, brown old yucca stems from, you know, a plant that you can find along the side of a road. In addition to that, you know, you can harvest some of the things that you grow in your garden like we've done here. And normally we're familiar with a hydrangea called Annabelle, which is a great garden plant. And sometimes we might like it in this nice green color. But if you wait long enough, you can find something in the way of brown that we've used around the edge and throughout this display. Additionally, one of my favorite gourds is the apple gourd, and this is the warded apple gourd. And this is really the first year I've grown this. I always like to grow something new in a garden. And you can even dry these. And then the other overriding tie-in is orange, and you can even grow your own orange pumpkins just like this. And this is a rather small one. Some of you can grow one a lot bigger than that. And just finding something like an old shears, and maybe in your basement or in your shed, you can just use something like this in this display. Now, the other thing I might recommend that you do is when you're done with this, if you really like one of your displays, take a picture of it and keep the picture so you can duplicate this year after year. Just like we like to accomplish in gardens, smooth flowing lines and softness of design, you can do the same thing like we've done here with these long green gourds. If you just look at it, it's very gentle, smooth, and scalloped, and it's very soft on the eyes. And I guess the overriding theme again on this is going to be the color green. So really, if you look at everything, it's a different shade of green, maybe with a little bit of white to brighten up this part of the display. Looking at display, you'll notice that this sort of flows. It's not just plopped in one corner of this entryway. So your eyes just don't stop. Your eyes start at the entryway and they flow outward into the garden. But the other thing that you might consider, instead of having floral displays in the home, you can create floral displays out of the home. And here we have a, you know, planter, and you can just take a plastic container and you can arrange all your flowers as we've done here with the ornamental grasses, the daily pods, the sunflowers, even the celosia. But remember, you can grow all these things in your garden, just like this new gourd that I grew in my garden this year, that I can dry and keep it from year after year. I'm Mark Viette. Join me next time in the garden.
For more garden tips, go to the In the Garden website at inthegardenradio.com.